Hello, my lovely friends. My name is Ava, and today I'm going to be giving you some romance recommendations all about novellas. I adore novellas, romance novellas, so much. I am in the mood currently for the past couple months. I've either only been able to listen to audiobooks or read a novella on my phone, and only those two things. So novellas are my life. I love them so much. And I just feel like they could be like a really great palate cleanser or just a fun little story that you can escape to for a very short time. So novellas for me are books that are either 150 pages or lower. I would say 150 pages or under is considered a novella to me. That's not considered a novella to everybody. Some people consider a book that's 200 pages a novella. Call a novella whatever you want. This is what I personally call a novella, you know? Let's get into these recommendations. I believe all of them, except for maybe one or two, are on Kindle Unlimited. So if you have KU, check these out. Okay, first I have A Novel Seduction by Claire Hastings. This says it's like number 11 in a series, which you don't have to read it in order at all. I just have only read this one and it was super fun. So this is about Evie and Drake. And when Evie was in college, she ended up starting to have this secret admirer who knew that she loved romance books so much. And so ever since she was in college, this anonymous person has been sending her romance books with all of the naughty bits highlighted and annotated, things like, I wish I could do this to you, or this is really hot, or we should try this out kind of thing. But she has no idea who's sending her these books. She secretly loved it, of course. It's years later. It's been a while since she has gotten a book, but it's years later. She's gone back to her hometown and she comes across Drake, who was the boy that she tutored in college. She may or may not figure out that Drake was the guy who was sending her those books, and they may or may not get together. This one was honestly super fun. So much fun to read. It's very short. I do wish this was a full-length book, but I will take what I can get. Next, we have a fan favorite for novellas. I, of course, adore Jessica Kane. I do. I love her. And so one of my favorites by her is called Hefty. Now, this one takes place in high school, but it is not a YA high school romance at all. I think both of the characters are 18. Zach is a bigger person, a football player. And Jill is his sister's best friend. And so they've known each other for quite a long time, and they have both been crushing hardcore over each other. But Zach thinks he can never get Jill because she is this skinny mini, a very popular cheerleader, but Jill just wants Zach. She wants a man who is as sweet and protective and hot as he is. And yeah, finally, at one point in this book, the dam finally breaks and they reveal their feelings for one another, and it gets very hot in maybe some public places. And it is so much fun. So much fun. I love this one. It's great. Next, I have three Ruby Dixon books to mention really fast. First, I have The Aliens Mail Order Bride by Ruby Dixon. This is book number 0.25 in the Rizdiverse series. So if you want to get into her Rizdiverse series, I recommend starting with this one. So this is about Emvor, who is an alien who is very lonely. He works alone on his farm on this farm planet, and he realizes that he's kind of getting older and he needs somebody on the farm to help him with chores and everything, but he can't afford to have someone work for him. So he's thinking, oh, I'll just order myself a bride in my own alien species. We're very strong. The women in my species are very strong women. So I'll just order a mail order bride to help me around the farm, but I won't fall in love with her. You know, I just need someone to help me with my farm. When the woman comes that he mail order brided to him, it's actually a human woman named Nicola, and she's trying to convince Emvor to let her stay and be his wife, and to help. But she's not big and strong and can like do some of the farm household chores, but she does everything to try to convince him to let her stay. She cooks for him. She becomes his companion. It's so cute. I really love this one. If you want a good mail order bride romance, this one is definitely it. Another Ruby Dixon is book number one in the Rizdiverse series. I do recommend reading the prequels though before this. There's a few prequels before book one, but this is book one. And it's actually available for you to listen for free if you go to the Read Me Romance podcast. They have the audiobook there for you if you want to listen to it. But this one's called When She's Ready. This is about Tessar and Leilani. And Leilani is a human woman, and they end up having to get in an arranged or marriage of convenience marriage to one another. And you figure out why when you read the book. And then the last Ruby Dixon I'm going to mention really fast is called Shift Just Got Real. This is the third book in the Bear Bites series, or the Shift series. There's like two different series names. This is the only book in that whole series that I liked. I gave all the rest of them, there's five in the series, like 3 stars or lower. And this one, the only one I gave 4 stars. So all the other books in the series are novellas as well. But I say you could just read this one on its own, honestly. So this is the romance between Ryan and Mal. This one is just so cute. Okay, so Mal is a bear shifter, okay? And he's kind of like older, I wanna say he's like 30s or something. And one day he's like shopping in the grocery store and he can scent his mate. Did I say he's a bear shifter? He's a bear shifter. And so he can scent his mate one day at the grocery store and he's like, oh my gosh, where is she? He's looking for her everywhere in this grocery store trying to find her because he has always wanted a mate. He's very lonely and so he wants that lifelong companionship. And so he finally sees her and he is devastated because it is Ryan, and Ryan is underaged and he's like, this is not good. This is not good. No, I cannot be with a woman who is underage, or a girl who's underage right now. And so he goes and runs away and lives in the mountains for a couple of years to distance himself from the temptation that is Ryan. It's years later, I think Ryan's now like 21, and they come across one another again, and Ryan admits her feelings for Mal because she is obsessed with him. And so she puts together a little scheme to help him finally tell her how he feels about her. And it is so cute. It's so good. Okay, I love this one. I kind of really want to reread it. So please check this one out. Next I have Set by Alexandria House. This one's more one of the longer novellas on this list, but it is 112 pages. It's so hot. This book is hot. So this is about a hero and heroine. They were in high school together, but they knew of each other, but they weren't friends or didn't hang out or anything like that. It's years later, I think it's like their 20 or 10 year high school reunion or whatever. They come across one another and they decide to get together and keep this relationship that they're having kind of secret, but kind of not. They don't really label it, but it's just hot and fun, and I loved reading this. Another short and sweet one is called The Babysitter by Jack Harbin. This is a male-male romance. One of the heroes is a college student who's a writer, and he's the babysitter to this couple who is getting a divorce. And so the hero writes kind of like steamy stories, and he ends up leaving his notebook at the family house. And so the next day he comes to pick it up and the dad is there and he gives it back to him and he's like, I may or may not have read some of your stories. And they get all hot and bothered together. This is really short, really sweet. I wish there's more just because the ending left me wanting more, but I need to read more of Jack Harbin for sure. Next I have one that's not called a romance book because it doesn't really end with the couple being together. It's just like a hot, fun time together, and at the end they go their separate ways. This is called Forbidden Fling by Kat Taylor, otherwise known as Katie Robert. So there is cheating in here, but I don't care. This is like one of the only books that I don't care if there's cheating. Our heroine in here, she goes on vacation with her boyfriend and his guy friends. Well, his guy friends end up tagging along and the boyfriend doesn't tell her. And so they're at this beach house, they're at her boyfriend's dad's beach house, and the dad is there. Her and the dad may or may not hook up because her boyfriend is being really crappy. And they have some very fun time during this vacation. If you just want to break from reality for a couple of pages, just pick this one up. Next I have Haven by Darcy Rose. I think this is also free to download, by the way, like a freebie if you want to download it. This one is about Eve and Dean. So when Eve was younger, tween age, her dad got remarried, and she now has a stepbrother named Dean. And Dean is a couple years older than her. Like, I think there's an age gap between the two, maybe like 10 years, 8 years older than her. And she's always had like a secret little crush on him, but Dean has never noticed her in that way until her 18th birthday. It's her 18th birthday, he comes to visit her for her party and everything. And right when he sees her on her 18th birthday, he is besotted. Like, he needs her now. But he's trying to hold himself back because he's like, I shouldn't want my stepsister. This isn't right. The two of them are really fighting their feelings for one another. And then the dam finally breaks and they get together, obviously. And lastly on this list, we have another alien romance book. We have Ash Planet Warriors by V.K. Ludwig. This is about Leah and Zarim. And Leah is a human woman. whose family spaceships ends up crashing on Zarim's planet. So Zarim ends up coming across the pod that she crashed in and ends up saving her and helping her acclimate to the world and getting her used to the world. And so yeah, the two of them spend a couple of days out in the alien wild together trying to survive. But then the two of them end up having to go to this city on the planet so that Leia can go back home. But while they're together, they have some pent-up tension between the two of them though the whole entire time that they're together. And it gets hot. There's some like artwork that this author has created about this couple, and on her, I think her website or her newsletter or whatever, I'm subscribed to her newsletter, and you need to go look at it. Cause it's good. It's good. I really enjoyed this one, and this is like a prequel novella to their full-length book. So like this book doesn't really necessarily, or this novella doesn't end in a happily ever after, but you have to read their full-length book to get the happily ever after, because this is like the prequel novel, because that's book number 0.5 in the Ash Planet Warrior series. So I thought this was super fun and hot though to read. So there you have it. Those are some romance novella recommendations for you. Please let me know down below if you've read any of these books or if you plan to. And if you have watched this far, leave me an alien emoji, because we did talk about a few alien romances in here. But yeah, thank y'all so much for watching. I will see y'all soon in my next one. Bye y'all.